Hi guys. I don't know where in the world you are right now, but there could be a snail watching you. Well, actually, this is kind of true. There are snails everywhere in the world. They're at the top of the mountains. They're in the deepest trenches of the sea, where, by the way, they eat starfish. And they're even in the desert. So maybe a snail is watching you right now. Anyway, I'm going to be painting a snail today, and you're invited to paint with me. And to paint this, we're going to need some supplies. So let's talk about what we need. Well, we need paper, of course, and I'm going to be using the hot press Fabiano Artistico 5x7 inch, and I like the hot press because I can get a lot more detail. I'm going to be using a washi tape to put around the edge of my paper to get a frame. I have a pencil and eraser so I can draw my picture. My brushes, I'll be using only 3 brushes. One is a size 4 silver black velvet, and it's relatively small. Then I have a nail brush that's much smaller, and if you're looking for a size, it's a 00. Then I have my very famous Princeton Neptune. This is 2 inches. You don't need 2 inches, obviously, but yeah, if you have a 1 inch brush, that's fine, but I do want to put an even swath of water on the paper, and I just can't get that with the smaller brush, so I will be using this brush here. And then at the very end, just to kind of save our time, we will be using Micron. This is a waterproof pen, just so we can get our dark black, and then we can get some whites with our jelly roll. And then, of course, we need our 5 watercolor paints and the Ecoline watercolor ink, which if you have a gouache, that's fine. And one other thing you'll need is 2 glasses of water. One is for rinsing your brush and the other for putting clean water on your palette. Okay, so we have our paper already prepared with the washi tape. And this is just a really thin stripe of washi tape. I don't need a lot. Okay, we're going to be drawing our little snail on the left side of the paper. And the bottom of the snail is going to be about 1 centimeter from the bottom. And I think the top of our snail could be about halfway plus a little bit, so maybe right in this area. Okay, and let's begin with the back of, you know, the snail's shell. And one part of it is going to be an oval. It's kind of like an egg, a little bit rounder on, or rounder on the bottom. It'll be a little bit rounder on the bottom. That looks pretty good to me. And we're going to put another one a little bit out, and not halfway mark, but a little bit higher. And it's going to be half the size of this one. And again, maybe a third of the size. And then a smaller one. This is out of balance. Two, right here. Okay, we'll erase some of these lines. And now we're going to have to draw another one. And this is going to be twice the size of this one. And the bottom, this will come down right here. So we're going to start here and then swoop it up. And we're going to have our little head coming around. It's a round head. It comes down, kind of a fat body. And the back is going to come close enough. Now let's draw a couple mushrooms. And I want one mushroom to come here. So it's above the, you know, so this shell is partly covering the mushroom. And I think I'll, so to the top and down. So, yes. And I'm gonna have another mushroom right here. Not the same height, coming down. And maybe part of that stem will be there. And we'll have a stem here. Okay, there are going to be some antennas on this. And sometimes there's these little droopy, I don't know what they are. That'll be cute. And I think for interest, I'm gonna add another mushroom on top. So how about, cute. And another one will be here. I think that'll be pretty cute. And over here we're going to have a dandelion. Center of the dandelion. Some fluff coming off of it. One leaf or two. And maybe a dandelion flying away. And another bit of fluff also flying. That will be it. Now, let's see what we can paint. Okay, so I think we'll just start with getting everything really wet. Nice even sheen of water. And I'm gonna paint this water on a little bit, keeping it smooth and even. The reason for that is I want some of that water to go into the paper, otherwise our paper will dry too fast. Okay, that should be tons. Here you can see there's a nice even sheen across the paper. So I'm going to go over here and pick up some of my colors. This is green gold, great for a background. This is azo yellow. And I believe I'm going to add in a little bit of quin sienna. That's pretty bright, so I'm going to tone that down. Okay, so to begin, let's add in. This place I'm going to keep white. So I have a dirty brush. What do you know? And I want the green to be more on the left and the brighter yellows to be on the right. That's pretty bright over there. So let me dilute it. I would like this to be a little bit whiter. Lift up some of that paint. And you know, we're going to do a little experiment. This is our liquid watercolor. Just need a little bit, not much. If you take gouache and drop some gouache in these areas, you get like pools of whiteness. Now it's a little bit different with the ink. It doesn't spread out as much, but it will still spread some because it's very wet right now. And I'm going to put some here around our little dandelion stem. No, it doesn't spread that much. Oh, look at that. It's really nice for spreading in a wet area. Brings everything back to white. Beautifully. And I think I want to get this all the way back to white. Make a nice contrast there. And just on the top of the head of that snail. Okay, I think we're going to paint in our soft colors of the mushroom. We're going to start with some Indanthrone Blue, and just a light layer, because it might bleed out beyond our mushroom right now, which isn't really, it's not too bad if it's a light bleed. And I'll get this side a little bit darker. This side, there's a puddle. It's kind of a dip. That one's much easier to paint. But I'm liking the texture over here. It's really cool. So it's a little bit more pigment, a little less water right now. I go along the edge. I'll leave this a little bit lighter. The light is coming from this side. Picking up slightly more pigment again. And right along that left edge, increasing the pigmentation. Okay, this one's really fuzzy. I'll just let that one dry a little bit more before I play with it. Okay, so I think we're going to make these. Maybe a greenish. Maybe we'll make them green-yellow. Oh, I like that color. Maybe that's the color we'll use. And this time I'm going to get it a little darker for that back one. Not touching that edge, just leave a little line there. Okay, so let's, before this gets really dry, ooh, I dropped the water. I'd like to get my blue in there. A little bit more pigmentation here. And I'm just adding a dark line. Oops. Okay, it's enough for our little mushrooms, I think. Unless we want to drop in a couple drops of white. See how that goes. Okay, so now let's probably should get this painted too. Go right up to the edge on one side, but not on the other. Blues and oranges make really nice browns or blacks, depends on how you know what the blue is or what the orange is. This is a rich brown and it's going to be great along this edge. Really beautiful brown. Okay, so let's get our shells painted. I'm just going to get everything damp again. And we're going to start out with a blue, which will be the shadow. And I'm just going to paint over all of these stems. We can get them white back later. So. So at the bottom, it's gonna be a little bit more intense. So I'm gonna do the same for this round of the shell, but I'm not gonna take the water all the way to this edge because the colors will bleed together and that would not be cool. Like that. Not cool. So I can just push all these blues down, it was going to be blue anyway. That might look cool though later. Yeah, I think that's going to work out okay. And I'm going to add just a little bit more blue right in this shadowed area. kind of cool how that looks. I'm going to add a little bit more here also. This is the lower part, so it will be darker. And just a little bit more intensity right here at the lower part. Okay, so now let's do this one. Third shell over, getting it, ooh, dirty brush. Getting it damp. Damp on the top. I'm dampening as much as possible so that wherever the paint stops, I'll have a hard edge there, but I don't want a hard edge right here. I want it right up to the edge if possible. Okay. It's kind of cool. As that dries, I'm going to put just a little more intensity right here at the right at the edge there. And also right here on this one. Okay, last one, and I'm not going to make this one really dark, I'm just going to have a hint of blue. Okay, let's paint the body. Yes, I have a dirty brush. Let me get it cleaner. So we're going to put in a little bit of blue shadowing. And then we're going to mix in some, this is my Payne's Gray. I'm going to take that Payne's Gray right up to the top there and drop it in. And now I'm going to pick up some of this, this Queen Sienna. All of these colors are just bleeding together, which is really cool. Getting cool transitions. Let that dry, and then I'm going to get some more light detail. It's too wet right now, I think. Okay, so I'm gonna get rid of some of that white. And I'm also gonna put in a little bit of an orange wash on top. I'm not sure I like that, but it's what it is right now. I'm going to add a little bit of an orange wash here also. Maybe just lines. come in with some bright orange just to give it some more pop in color. Okay, so this is my, what is this? This is my Payne's gray. I'm going to take it right here and just put it right along the edge. Payne's gray. Yeah. And you're probably thinking, oh, that's really ugly. Well, then let's go get some orange. And I'm going to drag the orange just below, just to make that either really bright or break up that color. And this is my green gold. Get some more of that red. And I'm going to dampen some of this area and then touch that. I think I'm going to dampen some more. Same over here. Thank you. are almost done. We just need our Ecoline watercolor ink to draw on our little mushroom stems and some other spots here and there. And then we can take our Micron pen, outline a few things, and we can call it a day. The Ecoline watercolor ink is much more opaque than gouache. I think it's easier to apply, and that's why I typically use it. Paint it first, and then we can add any color that we want on top of it. It's kind of cool to see dandelion fluff in a picture. So I just painted in everywhere. Okay, our painting pretty much is done, and it's time to do our inking. Okay, I'm going to speed it up from now on. I'm basically outlining. So this is a pen and wash, and a lot of times with a pen and wash, people do the pen first and then they do the wash. But if I did that, the colors would cover the ink. And so I did the watercolor first, and now I do the outlining with the ink. So I'm outlining everything. All of the mushrooms, the spots on the mushrooms, some of the stripes. I'm even creating some more spots on the neck of the snail, and in the middle of that spot, I'm going to add a bit of white. And there, I'm getting a lot of contrast. I'm putting a lot more interest and contrast in the foreground with my detailing than I do in the background. But anyway, in this painting, there are only 5 colors, and I didn't get a lot of contrast with the 5, and so by using the black and the white at the end, I'm creating the contrast. So at this time, I'm going to turn on the music and share some of the inking highlights. Happy inking!